Good morning, happy Friday and coffee talk. I am so glad to be back to join you guys. Last week I was out of town for my second bikini competition I've ever done in my life, and I want to do two at 50 years old. So I did that last Friday. So thank you to my business coach that jumped in and last minute spoke to you guys last Friday. Carla is amazing. I hope you guys can go back and listen to last Friday's. Good morning, Michelle. Good morning. Good morning. I'm so glad you're here. And I hope you can go back to last Friday and listen to Carla's great coffee talk. So I'm still trying to wake up, as you can tell. So I love these coffee talks. These are not coaching. These are not really kind of, these aren't supposed to be some major session. It's supposed to be just you and I having coffee, just as though we're having coffee together, just a casual conversation. And today is actually a really, really cool topic that I'm super, super excited about. And I actually, this is kind of the topic that I can like almost talk about, not blindfoldedly, but I love how to think differently, how we can grow and think differently as an influencer and as a leader, just honestly as a woman. How can we be more confident in who we are, and how can we be more confident as a leader? And as I'm getting my certifications with John Maxwell and graduate this summer, I'm super excited about that. I want to pour into you guys things that I'm learning, things that I'm like blown away about that's changing my life. And so this is pretty exciting. I love this topic. So we're gonna dive in, because I'm gonna give you, by the end of this, and these coffee talks aren't too long because I want to share where you get the information and you can apply it to your life. But I'm going to give you three ways to change the way you're thinking. And yes, I have notes because I am so ADD that I want to stay on track. And I want to make sure I give you the best information so you can go on and utilize this in your life and implement it. So did you guys know that your life is moving towards your strongest thoughts? So I had this conversation with my 16-year-old yesterday. So I was out of town for 4 or 5 days. I came back and my 16-year-old told me that he did not make the varsity team, okay? And he began to tell me and talk to me about how disappointed he was with himself, that he did not receive, his expectations didn't match what he was expecting. He knew he hadn't been applying himself. And if you know my kid, and you can probably relate to this with your children or with yourself, a lot of times you have the ability, you have the strength, you have the endurance, you are tough, you're strong, you know that you're good at what you do, right? At your job. You know you're amazing, but you keep like not excelling, or your expectations aren't matching exactly what the outcome is. And you're like, what the heck? What is going on? And so I had this conversation with him, and I thought I would share it here with you, because I told him, dude, I have 3 boys, so I'm all about dude, sorry. But I'm like, dude, you have the ability. First, I asked him permission if I can give him advice, because with a 16-year-old, and really with a professional or anybody, you want to ask permission, because that means as soon as they say yes, that opens their heart and their mind to what you're about to say. So that's a side business tip. But I asked him for permission. Can I give you advice? He said yes. So I said, dude, you have the ability, you have the strength. Everybody knows how good Miles is. But guess what? Miles doesn't think that, he doesn't think the way that he matches up. And his mindset, I told him, is everything. And of course, you know, he knows what mindset is because his mom's a coach. But I had to explain to him, the way you're thinking is resulting into the outcome that you have. So if you want to change your outcome, you can't change how hard you practice, the things you're doing in your business. If you're doing the same routine and you've got this power hour and you've got it all lined out perfectly, you get a checklist, you got everything going for you, but you're still getting the same end result, which is you're not making $50,000 a month like you want. You don't have 10 new clients. You don't have 10 new whatever. Your products aren't selling. Nothing is moving, right? And here's the game changer that all this is about. And that I told my son, the only way you're going to make varsity is you have to change the way you're thinking. And this goes with you and I in our business and the way we think about ourselves and the way we think about the abilities that we have for ourselves. You have to change the way you're thinking. Okay, so I'm going to dive in for the three tips that I want to give you today. I hope that made sense. Give me some love, hearts, or like tell me you're live, tell me you're on the replay, but let me know if this is resonating with you, because I want to know if this is resonating with you. If not, then I guess I'll just sip my coffee, but anyway, it's all good. But okay, three ways to change the way you're thinking. The first one is, and this is to grow your thinking, right? We all want to grow our thinking and be better as a woman, right? As an individual person, how can we be better? And it all results in the thinking. Okay, I'm going to shut up. Let's dive in. Number one, good morning, Tabitha. Thanks for joining, girlfriend. There's a power leader right there. Follow Tabitha if you guys need a realtor. She's amazing. Okay, so number one, find someone. I put 10 times ahead of you. Find that one person. So whatever business, maybe you're a realtor, a new realtor, right? Find somebody that is way ahead of you, because I guarantee their thinking is a lot different than the way you're thinking. So if you're a realtor, you can hook up with Tabitha if she's open to that. I'm sure she is. She's an amazing powerhouse woman. But that if you're a realtor, new realtor, if you're a new business coach, if you are trying to lose weight or you're trying to exercise, like find somebody that is way ahead of you. Meet up with them. That's why they say, who's your average of your five? Like you grow and you want to be of the average of your five. You want to be at the bottom because you want to grow to their mindset, right? So when you hang out with people that are doing big things, like it shifts your mindset. Like you get blown away, right? I guarantee if you sat with Tabitha, because she's very successful at what she does as a realtor. If you sat with her and talked to her, I guarantee your mind would probably be blown away. And that's what happens when you get with other leaders that are 10 steps ahead of you. They open your mind to the possibilities, and they open your mind to the thought of shifting the direction that you thought you were going to where you need to go. Or you collaborate and you meet in the middle and you become amazingly aware of the things that you should be doing, right? And the way that they are thinking is mind-blowing. You'll be mind blown. So that's step number one, is get next to somebody, have coffee with somebody that's 10 steps ahead of you. So when you hear the way they're thinking, you're gonna be blown away. And that's what you want. That's what you want. So, and that's gonna be able to help you shift. So number two, watch where you push back the most. This one's really good. This is like, I love self-reflecting, self-coaching. I like looking at myself every day and going, you know, where do I need to grow today? Well, who do I need to serve today? What do I need to be doing today, right? And number two is watch where you push back. So when you self-reflect, or maybe you're not sure how to self-reflect, maybe you're talking to your leader, maybe you're talking to someone that's 10 steps ahead of you, and maybe you're saying things like, that's not true for me. That's wrong. Maybe you're argumentative in your head. Maybe you're thinking, you know, the way they're doing it, is it right? Maybe you're thinking, that's not right for you. That's not for you. It's not meant for you. Maybe whatever you're thinking, if you are hesitating and you are self-doubting, or you're even doubting them, but they're still 10 steps ahead of you. Like that is a resistance from the devil, and it's resistance from you. And you know, when they say, I think Rachel Hollis says it, like, get out of your own damn way. This is the perfect example. When you're talking to a leader and you're talking to somebody that's 10 steps with you. Good morning, Leslie. Good to see you, girlfriend. When you're talking to somebody that's up leveling and 10 steps ahead of you, and you find yourself thinking negative, or you're arguing with them in your head, girl, get out of your own way, like Rachel Hollis says. That is the best like self-reflection you can give yourself, is when you find yourself arguing or hesitating. That's where the growth happens. Exactly like beginning, I told you the story about my teenager. He didn't make varsity and he wants to know, he wants to give up, but that's his mindset. And that's why he needs to think differently, because he has all the ability. He's just not thinking the way Michael Jordan thinks, right? And I told him, you gotta have the Michael Jordan mentality in your business and at what you're doing. And what's gonna make Miles stand out is talking to a coach, stepping out of his comfort zone, talking to somebody that's 10 steps ahead of him, like a coach, talking to the team captain. And I told him, these things are uncomfortable, but that's where the growth happens. When you're doing the uncomfortable and you're self-reflecting and you're realizing that you're hesitating or arguing with somebody and you're like, okay, that should be a reflection where you go, why am I arguing with somebody when they are making $1 million? They're 10 steps ahead of me. Why am I arguing? That should be something humbling for yourself to go, okay, I need to really dive deep in within myself and find out, why am I arguing? Why am I hesitating? Maybe you're scared to take those steps. And maybe there's envy, maybe there's ego. And that's something that's progress and it's learned. I still do it. I have to let my ego down. I have to humble myself. And I am not perfect, guys. I always want to grow, especially when I make mistakes. And when I make mistakes, I just pray the people around me forgive me. And I hope that you guys ask for forgiveness and do the same. Okay. Let's dive into number 3. Be willing to be wrong, right? Ooh, that's a good one. Be willing to be wrong. And this is more so for the people that have to do everything themselves. They're afraid to give up leadership. They're afraid to give up and delegate because that's what leaders do. Leaders are influencers, and leaders know how to trust other leaders. It's trusting the right leaders. And I really could end from there, because that alone, if you think about it, is mind-blowing. But I want you to think about it, because I used to think that the best leaders needed a title. The best leaders, they were the ones like, you know, they had this big executive position, you know? And I used to think that leaders were they knew all the details, right? But the best thing that you could do is, and what I realized is that leaders recognize the areas that are wrong, but leaders are the best leaders don't need a title, right? They just influence. Leaders trust other leaders, and you want to trust the right leaders, because you can have so many leaders that know it all and that are detail oriented, which are fabulous, right? You want them on your team, right? You want high level people that are thinkers and perfectionists and overthinkers, right? And the ones that are bossy and the ones that are like really dominant, right? But you want the ones that you can trust and that are willing to grow with you, right? Because it's a big difference, because you can be a boss or you could be a leader. And there's two different things. So you don't want to be bossy. You want to be a leader and a leader of influence. Okay, those are really it. I'm going to do kind of a series of leadership the next few weeks. I really want to talk about empowerment next week, next Friday. And I really want to talk about the possibilities to inspire and not motivate. And your homework assignment today, guys, I don't ever give homework assignments because this is not a class, but I thought this was fun. So I want you to think about how you're thinking. How are you thinking as a leader and as a business, as an entrepreneur? How are you thinking about yourself, your business? Because if you want a different outcome, if you want a different result, you have to change the way you're thinking. It's just down to it. And if you need help and you are stuck, because I have so been there, then you reach out to me. I'll send you a link. We'll have a free conversation and I can push you along where you're not seeing it. Sometimes what we don't know, we don't know. And sometimes we don't see what we don't know. I mean, it's mind-boggling. But when you're around other people that are successful and doing big things, they will help you think bigger. So connect with me, DM me so we can get you thinking bigger and better. And stay tuned because next week is going to be about leadership and empowerment. And we're going to talk about the possibilities of inspiring and not motivating. And I want you to think about what you're thinking. And don't, if you don't like the direction where you're going and you don't want to repeat last year, this year, boom, change your thinking. So pay attention to what you're thinking. Yes, iron sharpens iron. That is like, I love that, Tabitha. Thanks for sharing that because that's like a big motto of mine. You need to surround yourself with other iron. I mean, we sharpen each other and that's the way women should be. All right, that's it. I'm going to enjoy my second cup of coffee. I'm going to save this video and I'm going to upload it on my YouTube. So if you need to follow my YouTube, you can go there. All these, even the power words, all that is on my YouTube. I save almost every coffee talk and I throw it into the YouTube so we can save it. So if you want to share it with somebody, add them to this group. Love you guys so much. Have an amazing Friday. Tabitha, thank you for joining. Vanessa, thank you for being here. Good morning, good morning. Go back and listen to the replay. This was really good. All right, love you guys. Bye.